أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط. صدق الله العظيم.
من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In ayah number 33, which we had already read, there is again the style of hasf, as I told you. Certain words are deleted because they are understood. أَفَمَنْ هُوَ قَائِمٌ عَلَىٰ كُلِّ نَفْسٍ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ. So just imagine, he who is watching every soul on what he has earned. Can he be equal to a person or any other person who doesn't know anything? The deities that you have, you know, concocted, forged, they don't know anything. وَجَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ شُرَكَىٰ. And they have declared with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as partners. قُلْ سَمُّوهُمْ. Ask them. Now just give the names. Who are they? أَمْ تُنَبِّئُونَهُ بِمَا لَا يَعْلَمُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. Do you want to tell him, Allah, what he doesn't know in the heavens and the earth? Now this is shafa'a. As I explained, you know, earlier also. If you go and you want to intercede in some matter, what do you say? Well, the facts on the file, you know, they are different, but I know the reality. This case is not like that, which appears, you know, according to the file of the case. I can tell you the reality. Can anybody say this to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Doesn't he know everything? أَتُنَبِّئُونَهُ بِمَا لَا يَعْلَمُ فِي الْأَرْضِ. أَمْ بِظَاهِرٍ مِنَ الْقَوْلِ. Now, what is it? You believe in this intercession on what basis? Or it is only, you know, that you are uttering some words without meaning them. بَلْ زُيِّنَ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مَكْرَهُمْ وَصُدُّوا عَنِ السَّبِيلِ. But you know, all these concoctions, that their own, you know, designed their ideas, their own man-made ideas, they have been made beautiful for them. People very much like, you know, oh, we can have the shafa'ah. He will save us. And you know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not be able to turn back his shafa'ah. All these things, you know, absolutely nonsense. But people cling to these things. وَمَنْ يُضْلِ اللَّهُ مَا لَهُ مِنْهَا. And those who have gone to that extent, now there cannot be anybody who can take them to the right path. لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. For them there is punishment in this life of this world also. وَلَعَذَابُ الْآخِرَةِ أَشَقُّ. And the punishment of the hereafter is going to be the hardest. وَمَا لَهُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَاقِ. And there is no savior for them from Allah. Now the savior, Jesus is the savior, our Lord. Because we believe in him, he will save us. All our sins are condoned only by believing in Jesus. All these things, you know. But there are Muslims also who hold such ideas. مَثَلُ الْجَنَّةِ الَّتِي وَعِدَ الْمُتَّقُونَ. The similitude of the Jannah, the garden, which has been promised to the God-fearing people. تَجْرِي مِنْ تَعْتِ الْأَنْهَارِ. Rivers will be flowing underneath it. أُكُلُهَا دَائِمٌ وَظِلُّهَا. Its fruit will also be perpetual and its shades will also be perpetual. Now why this word muscle? Because we can't imagine what will be the state of affairs in Jannah. That is beyond our imagination. There is a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, مَا لَا عَيْنٌ رَاتْ وَلَا عُذُنٌ سَمِعَتْ وَمَا قَتَرَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِ بَشَرْ. The real blessings of Jannah are which no eye has ever seen, no ears have ever heard about them, and no idea has ever come to any human mind, because that is a different world altogether. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us, you know, some imagination by these words which we know. So there is some similarity, but you know, essentially there is a world of difference between these two things. تِلْكَ عُقْبَ الَّذِينَ التَّقْوَى. That will be the end of those who had taqwa. وَعُقْبَ الْكَافِرِينَ النَّارِ and the end of these who disbelieve, that is going to be fire. وَالَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَفْرَعُونَ بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ and those whom we gave the book, that is the Jews and the Christians, يَفْرَعُونَ they are rejoicing بِمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ on what has been sent down on you, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now, because till this time, the direct address to the Jews has not started. It would be started after Hijrah, when Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam went to Medina, and then you know in Surah Al-Baqarah we find those 10 sections continuous, addressing them. But now the Jews at Medina were listening, that there has, you know, come up a person in Makkah who believes in Moses, who believes in David. All these are, you know, our heroes. We know them. These pagan Arabs didn't know them. And he says that actually Torah was given to Moses. And he confirms all these things. He confirms that Zabur was given to David. So actually they were happy to begin with that there is a confirmation. And what Muhammad is preaching and what he is saying is confirming their position, strengthening their position. Later on their reaction was somewhat else. But in the beginning, you know, they said at least in this Arabian Peninsula, there are people now who believe in those, which we call, you know, the prophets of the Old Testament. We believe in all the prophets of the Old Testament. And who are they? They are, so to say, the heroes of these Jews. They believe in them. So actually, because Quran was confirming Torah, Quran was confirming Injil, Quran was confirming Jesus, Quran was confirming Moses, and so on, so they were happy. وَمِنَ الْأَحْزَابِ مَنْ يُنْكِرُ بَعْضَهُ And among the groups, there are, you know, who deny some of it. قُلْ إِنَّمَا أُمِرْتُ أَنْ أَعْبُدَ اللَّهَ وَلَا أُشْرِكَ بِهِ شَيْءٍ وَلَا أُشْرِكَ بِهِ Proclaim, O Muhammad, I have been commanded that I have to obey and worship Allah. And I cannot associate anything, anybody with Him. إِلَيْهِ أَدْعُو And I am calling you to Him. وَإِلَيْهِ مَعَاب And to Him is going to be my return. وَكَذَلِكَ أَنزَلْنَا حُكْمًا عَرَبِيًّا And this is why we have sent down this book, this Quran, as a judgment in Arabic, authority in Arabic. Because the Arabs, you know, they are to be addressed first of all. وَلِلْتَبَعْتَ أَهْوَاهُمْ بَعْدَ مَا جَاكَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ And if, supposedly, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you follow their wishes, after that, this ilm, this knowledge, real knowledge has come to you, مَا لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَلَيِّمْ وَلَا وَاقْ Then there will be no protector for you and no savior for you from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Very stern words. Now you have to, whether it pleases them or not, whether they like it or not, you have to be firm on Tawheed and you have to be firm on whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending upon you. وَقَذَلِكَ أَنزَلْنَا حُكْمًا عَرَبِيًّا وَلَيْنِ تَبَعْتَ أَهْوَاهُمْ بَعْدَ مَا جَاكَ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ مَا لَكَ مِنَ اللَّهِ مِنْ وَلِيٍّ وَلَا وَاقْ وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلًا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ Now this is the only ayah in this whole surah which refers to the messengers, the former messengers. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا رُسُلًا مِنْ قَبْلِكَ وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُمْ أَزْوَاجًا وَذُرِّيَّةً We had sent messengers before you also. And we gave them wives also, and you know, and the progeny, sons and daughters, they also married. They had also had the offsprings. وَمَا كَانَ لِرَسُولٍ يَأْتِيَ بِآيَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ And it has never been in the power of any messenger to bring any miracle, to show any miracle, to bring any sign, except with the command and leave and permission of Allah. لِكُلِّ أَجَلٍ كِتَابٍ And all these, you know, fixed periods of time, they have been recorded. What is the time for them? Till what time they will be given this respite? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has a complete record of it. يَمْهُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ وَيُثْبِتُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He just blocks out what He wants, what He wishes, and establishes Yusmit, and He establishes what He wants. Now this relates to, as far as I think, the Naskh, you know. There was a command in Torah, now abrogated. Another command has come in Quran. Although, both the books are from Allah. Even in Quran, there was some command in the early days, then they were abrogated, another command was, you know, given in its place. The bequest for every Muslim who was dying was made essential, obligatory. كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمْ إِذَا حَضَرَ أَحَدَكُمُ موت و ان طرح کا خیر علی وسیعت والدین والاقربین، بٹ وین دی لا آف انہیریٹنس کیم اٹ واز ایبروگیٹڈ، ناؤ اٹ از ناٹ نیسسری. اف یو وانٹ ٹو میک اے بیکویسٹ دین اونلی ون تھرڈ آف یور ٹوٹل پراپرٹی یو نو یو کین میک دی بیکویسٹ فار دیٹ، ناٹ مور دین. سو دس دس کمز یم اللہ ما یشا و یثبت، وٹ سو ایور اللہ وانٹس ٹو کیپ اینڈ ریٹین ہی ریٹینس، اینڈ وٹ ایور ہی وانٹس یو نو ٹو بلاٹ آؤٹ ہی بلاٹس آؤٹ. وعندہ ام الکتاب اینڈ ود ہم از دی مدر آف دی بکس. وعندہ لفی ام الکتاب لدینا لعلی حکیم لوح محفوظ. آئی ٹولڈ یو آن دی ویری فرسٹ ڈے دیٹ ایکچولی دس قرآن از دی اٹیسٹڈ کاپی آف دیٹ بک، دی ریئل بک از دیئر فی لوح محفوظ، بل ہوا قرآن مجید فی لوح محفوظ فی کتاب مکنون فی ام الکتاب. That is the real book and these are the attested copies. Just, you know, a judge writes a judgment and that judgment remains there in the official record. Only attested copies of those judgments can be given to the parties. This is an attested copy of the judgment written by judge so and so. And then this is actually an attested copy. وَإِمَّا نُرِيَنَّكَ بَعْضَ الَّذِينَ نَعِدُهُمْ. And it is also possible that we show you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, some of what we have been threatening them with. The azab may come in your lifetime. أَوْ نَتَوَفَّيَنَّكَ. And it is also possible that we take you back. We possess you. فَإِنَّمَا عَلَيْكَ الْبَلَاغُ. Anyhow, in any case, on you the responsibility is of conveying. وَعَلَيْنَا الْحِسَابُ. Reckoning and taking account is our business, not yours. أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا نَأْتِي الْأَرْضَ نَنْقُصُهَا مِنْ أَطْرَافِهَا. Are they not seeing that we go on diminishing the land on its borders from them? I told you, know, in my lecture on the methodology of the Islamic revolution and the revolution of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the zone of influence of Quraysh was diminishing day by day. And the zone of influence of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was increasing. Even before Hijrah, because his message was spreading, although he had, you know, spent all his time at Makkah during at least the first 10 years. But you know, the news had gone to far and wide regions. And in this tribe, certain peoples have come to believe. In this tribe also, again, certain peoples have come to believe. The message was progressing every day. And what did it mean? Actually, all these things are going towards Makkah, as if advancing towards Makkah. So Makkah is being encircled. These Quraysh and these Mushrikeen are being encircled. And the circle is becoming closer and closer to them. أَوَلَمْ يَرَوْا أَنَّا نَاتِ الْأَرْضَ نَنْقُصُهَا مِنْ أَطْرَافِهَا وَاللَّهُ يَحْكُمُ وَلَا مُعَقِّبَ لِحُكْمِهِ. It is Allah who commands, decides. And there is no repeller of His command. Whosoever, whatever He commands, it is executed. وَهُوَ سَرِيُّ الْحِسَابِ. And He is very swift in reckoning. وَقَدْ مَكَرَ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِهِمْ فَلِلَّهِ الْمَكْرُ جَمِيعًا. Those people also who were before them, they made devices and plans how to stop this message and how to stop these messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلِلَّهِ الْمَكْرُ جَمِيعًا. All their plans are under the control of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يَعْلَمُ مَا تَكْسِبُ كُلُّ نَفْسٍ وَسَيَعْلَمُ الْكُفَّارُ لِمَنْ عُقْبَى الدَّارِ. He knows whatever every soul is earning. And very soon these kuffar, these disbelievers, these rejectors of the faith will come to know for whom is the happy abode in the hereafter. وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَسْتَ مُرْسَلًا. And these kuffar who have rejected you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they are saying, you are not a messenger of Allah. لَسْتَ مُرْسَلًا. قُلْ كَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا بَيْنِي وَبَيْنَكُمْ. Tell them, Allah is sufficient as a witness between me and you. He knows that He has sent me. He is sufficient for testifying. He testifies that I am His messenger. وَمَنْ عِنْدَهُ عِلْمُ الْكِتَابِ. And in addition to Allah, those people also who have the knowledge of the book, these people sitting in Medina or in Najran, there were Christians in Najran, south of Makkah. There were Jews in Medina, north of Makkah. So these people also know and they also testify because they had all the signs of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in their books. And we have read this ayah, يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاهُمْ. They know Him and recognize Him just as they recognize their own sons. So Allah testifies that I am the messenger of Allah and those people also who have the knowledge of the book. Now we are proceeding to the second surah of this pair. سورة ابراہیم علیہ الصلاۃ والسلام. بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. الف لام را. کتاب انزلناہ الیک. This is a book which we have sent down to you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لتخرج الناس من الظلمات الى النور, so that you bring out people from all shades of darknesses into the light. بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ. But this you will be able to do with the leave of Allah, with the permission of Allah. Not that whomsoever you want to bring out from the darkness, you can bring it. No, this authority is not with you. إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءَ. But you have to try for that. بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ إِلَىٰ صِرَاطِ الْعَزِيزِ الْحَمِيدِ. To the path of Allah who is Al-Aziz, Almighty, and who is Hamid, who is praiseworthy, and who is praised him in himself, self-praised. اللہ الذی لہ ما فی السماوات و ما فی الارض. Allah is He to whom belongs everything which is in the heavens and in the earth. وَوَيْلُ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ عَذَابٍ شَدِيدٍ. And woe to the disbelievers from severe chastisement and punishment that is going to be their lot. الَّذِينَ يَسْتَحِبُّونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا. Those who have preferred this life of this dunya عَلَى الْآخِرَةِ, over the hereafter. This is the crucial thing. Which life you prefer? Life of here, this world, or the life of hereafter? This is crucial. You have to make a choice. You know, you may say that you are believing in Akhirah, but actually your behavior will show which one you are preferring, this life or that life. What amount of your time and energy is there being spent for that life, and how, what amount or percentage of your time and energies and all your, you know, your say your jod and all your working is devoted only to the requirements of this life. This is actually, your conduct will show it. الَّذِينَ يَسْتَحِبُّونَ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا عَلَى الْآخِرَةِ وَيَسُدُّونَ عَنْ سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. And they themselves held back from the path of Allah and stop other also. وَيَبْغُونَهَا عِوَجًا. And they want to find crookedness, mistakes with the message of Allah. أُولَٰئِكَ فِي ضَلَالٍ بَعِيدٍ. They have gone far astray. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِن رَسُولٍ إِلَّا بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ. And we didn't send any messengers but with the tongue, with the language of his own nation. لَيُبَيِّنَ لَهُمْ. So that he explains it to his nation. Had he been sent with some foreign language, it couldn't be intelligible for his nation, for his people. So every prophet of Allah, every messenger of Allah, to him the revelation came in his own tongue, in his own language. Because, you know, Torah was in Hebrew, Quran is in Arabic. Maybe if somebody was sent, we can't say for sure, but if someone, as we know, essentially as a principle, must have been sent in, you know, such a big country. What a big chunk of humanity lives in China. There must have been sent some prophet. You know, the revelation to him must have come in Chinese language. So this is the rule. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَا مِنْ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ بِلِسَانِ قَوْمِهِ لِيُبَيِّنَ لَهُمْ فَيُذِلُّ اللَّهُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ. When it is all explained and made clear, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends astray whomsoever likes. And he guides whomsoever he likes. And I have told you many a time, this can go both ways. Allah guides whomsoever he likes. He likes, and Allah guides whosoever wants to be guided. And Allah, you know, sends astray whomsoever He decides, or you can say Allah sends astray to whomsoever He wants to go astray Himself. So Allah gives him, leaves him alone, go which way you want to go. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. And He is Al-Aziz, having all power and authority, and Hakim, having all wisdom. وَلَقَدْ أَرْسَلْنَا مُوسَى بِآيَاتِنَا. And we have sent Musa with our signs and miracles. And أَخْرِجْ قَوْمَكَ مِنَ الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ. Bring out, try to bring up out your people from all shades of darknesses, shade of shirk, shade of kufr, shade of materialism, and so on. الظُّلُمَاتِ إِلَى النُّورِ, to the light of Iman. وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. Now this term which I have been using, you know, for so many days, you find this term in Quran. ذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. Now admonish them, remind them, by mentioning to them the big days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which were those big days? In which whole nations were annihilated. Whole communities made as if they never lived. Kallam yagnaw fiha. The whole people of Nuh drowned. The whole people of Hud, the Aad, the big nation, they finished, exterminated, annihilated. So those days in which these big commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala were executed, they are called Ayyamullah. They are the days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. As I told you, in Makki surahs, one surah of the pair, it will more emphasize التَذْكِيرْ بِآلَاءِ اللَّهِ. And the other, you will more find التَذْكِيرْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ. This is the term over here. وَذَكِّرْهُمْ بِأَيَّامِ اللَّهِ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ الْآيَاتٍ لِكُلِّ صَبَّارٍ شَكُورٍ. Definitely in those أَيَّامِ اللَّهِ, in those stories and events, there are signs for those who are steadfast and grateful. وَإِذْ قَالَ مُوسَى لِقَوْمِهِ اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. And when Moses said to his people, Bani Israel, اذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ, just remember the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that came to you. إِذْ أَنْجَاكُمْ مِنْ آلِ فِرْعَوْنَ, when he delivered you from the people of Fir'aun. يَسُومُونَكُمْ سُوَ الْعَذَابِ. Now just remember the wordings of Surah Al-Baqarah. The same words are appearing here. And I am only, you know, drawing your attention to it so that you know. These surahs are closer regarding the period of their revelations. Because they are just before Hijrah, Surah Al-Baqarah just after Hijrah. يَسُومُونَكُمْ سُوَ الْعَذَابِ. They were inflicting you with the worst of the chastisements. What was it? وَيُزَبِّحُونَ أَبْنَاكُمْ. They were killing and slaying and murdering your sons. وَيَسْتَحْيُونَ نِسَاءَكُمْ. And they were keeping your women and your female children, female offsprings alive. وَفِي ذَلِكُمْ بَلَاءٌ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ. Definitely in it there was a grievous trial for you from your Lord. وَيَسْتَأْذَنَ رَبُّكُمْ. And just remember, when your Lord proclaimed, لَئِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you are grateful, if you show gratefulness, we have given you these blessings. We have given you the book, Torah. If you show gratefulness, لَازِدَنَّكُمْ. I'll give you more and more. My blessings will be increased. وَلَئِنْ كَفَرْتُمْ. But if you prove to be ungrateful, unthankful, thankless people, إِنَّ عَذَابِي لَشَدِيدٌ, then my chastisement is also very severe. وَقَالَ مُوسَىٰ إِنْ تَكْفُرُوا أَنْتُمْ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ. And Musa said to them, if you or all who live in the world, in the whole of the earth, if they become kuffar, if they deny Allah, if they reject Allah, if they are ungrateful to Allah, فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ لَغَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ, they will not be able to do any harm to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is laghani. He is self-sufficient. He doesn't need anything. And he is self-praised. And he is praiseworthy or self-praised. أَلَمْ يَعْتَكُمْ لَبَوُ الَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. Now you know, as I told you in this surah, the name will not be taken. But you know, all of these messengers, they are mentioned as one. وَإِنَّ هَذِهِ أُمَّتُكُمْ أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً. Now because they are أُمَّةً وَاحِدَةً, they are mentioned here as a group. أَلَمْ يَأْتِكُمْ نَبَأُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ قَوْمِ نُوحٍ وَعَادٍ وَثَمُودَ وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ. Have not the news of those people, those nations who are before you reached you? That is, the nation of Nuh, and the Aad, and the Samud, وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِمْ, and those who were after them. You know, because Madian and Hazrat Lut alayhi salatu wasalam, they and Hazrat Musa, they were all after them. لَا يَعْلَمُهُمُ اللَّهُ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Nobody knows all of them except Allah. Because there had been many messengers, many prophets in other parts of the world. لَا يَعْلَمُهُمْ إِلَّا اللَّهُ. Nobody knows all of them except Allah. جَاتْهُمْ رُسُلُهُمْ بِالْبَيِّنَاتِ. Their messengers came to them with clear teachings, clear signs, even miracles. فَرَدُّوا أَيْدِيَهُمْ فِي أَفْوَاهِهِمْ. They thrust their hands into their mouths. Now this is an idiom, and it can have two meanings. Sign of wondering. How can it happen? We never heard of it, that a messenger coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Or in anger. In anger also, you know, somebody takes his fingers into his mouth. They thrust their hands into their mouths. وَقَالُوا إِنَّا كَفَرْنَا بِمَا أُرْسِلْتُمْ بِهِ. And they said, all of them, we disbelieve what you have been sent with. وَإِنَّا لَفِي شَكِّمْ مِمَّا تَدْعُونَنَا إِلَيْهِ مُرِيبِ. And definitely and verily, certainly, what you are calling us to, we are in a very disquieting and perturbing doubt about it. We can't be sure. You say you are the messenger of Allah. How can we be sure? You say whatever you are saying is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of the heavens and the earth. How can we be sure? So we have all the doubts. قَالَتْ رُسُلُهُمْ. Now the messenger, now here they are being mentioned collectively. قَالَتْ رُسُلُهُمْ. Their messenger said, أَفِ اللَّهِ الشَّكُّ الْفَاطِرِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Have you any doubts about Allah, who is the originator of all the heavens and the world and the earth? يَدْعُوكُمْ لَيَغْفِرَ لَكُمْ مِنْ ذُنُوبِكُمْ. He is calling you, and we are calling you on his behalf. Actually, he is calling you. يَدْعُوكُمْ لَيَغْفِرَ لَكُمْ. So that he pardons you, he forgives you from your sins. وَيُوَخِّرْكُمْ إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّىٰ. And he defers your case and postpones it for a fixed period of time. قَالُوا إِنْ أَنْتُمْ إِلَّا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُنَا. They said, oh, you are also just human beings like us. You can't claim to be messengers of Allah. تُرِيدُونَ أَنْ تَصُدُّونَ عَمَّا كَانَ يَعْبُدُ آبَاؤُنَا. You want to stop us from worshipping what our forefathers used to worship. فَاتُونَا بِسُلْطَانٍ مُبِينٍ. If it is so, you must produce some clear authority, manifest authority, some visible sign and miracle. قَالَتْ لَهُمْ رُسُلُهُمْ. Their messengers said to them, إِنَّهْنُ إِلَّا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ. We are nothing but humans like you. وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَمُنُّ عَلَىٰ مَنْ يَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ. But it is for Allah. He favors, bestows his favors on whomsoever he likes from his bondsmen. He has favored us with revelation. He has favored us, chosen us as prophets, as messengers. وَمَا كَانَ لَنَا نَاتِيَكُمْ بِسُلْطَانِ اللَّهِ بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. And it is not in our powers to bring to you some signs, some miracle, except with the leave of Allah, with the permission of Allah. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. And all who believe in Allah must put their faith in Him. وَمَا لَنَا اللَّهِ نَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ نَتَوَكَّلَ عَلَى اللَّهِ وَقَدْ هَدَانَا سُبُلَنَا. And what is to us? What can happen to us? What can be the reason to us? Why shouldn't we place all our faith and confidence and trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And He has shown us, He has led us to His paths. وَلَنَصْبِرَنَّ عَلَىٰ مَا آذَيْتُمُونَا. And we shall show patience. We shall be steadfast. We shall persevere on what persecution you are giving to us. وَعَلَى اللَّهِ فَلْيَتَوَكَّلِ الْمُتَوَكِّلُونَ. And whosoever has to place his trust in anybody, he should place the trust in Allah. He is the most trustworthy. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لِرُسُلِهِمْ. And said those people who disbelieved their messengers to the messengers, لَنُخْرِجَنَّكُمْ مِنْ أَرْضِنَا. We shall expel you from our lands, our cities, our towns. أَوْ لَتَعُودُنَّ فِي مِلَّتِنَا. Or you have to come back to our beliefs, our creeds, the forefathers, you know, whatever the creed was of forefathers, you have to come back to the folds of that. فَأَوْحَا إِلَيْهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ لَنُهْلِكَنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ. Then their Lord sent them the revelation that now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to destroy these evildoers. Now this is the limit, time limit. When the nations gave the final, you know, ultimatum. Now you come back or we shall kill you. You come back to the fold of the religion and creed of your forefathers, or we shall expel you. As we had those words, you know, لَيَسْمِتُوكَ أَوْ يَقْتُلُوكَ أَوْ يُخْرِجُوكَ. When this decision is taken by the nation, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives the final verdict. Now you go away, you make hijrah, and we are going to destroy this whole nation. So, أَوْحَا إِلَيْهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ. Now we are going to destroy and annihilate these evildoers. And now we shall make you dwell in the land after them. Just as after the people of Nuh, the people of Hud sprang up. And they were the people, men of strength and civilization and culture. And after they were destroyed, then Samud came up in the Arabian Peninsula. ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ خَافَ مَقَامِي وَخَافَ وَعِيدٍ. And this is for whom, who fears my threat and who fears of standing before me. خَافَ مَقَامِي. أَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى. Whosoever fears, you know, that one day I'll have to stand before my Lord for that grand accountability of the Day of Judgment. Whosoever has this fear, and whosoever has fear of my threats, and then they will be saved. وَاسْتَفْتَهُ وَخَابَ كُلُّ جَبَّارٍ عَنِيدٍ. And they demanded a judgment. And all the tyrants and the obstinates, they were destroyed and they were humiliated, disappointed. Now this is the same judgment about which we had at the ayah in Surah Al-Anfal. In tastaftahu faqad ja'akumul fath. Abu Jahl said, this day, Yawmul Furqan, is going to be the day of judgment. It will prove who is on the right path. Because he was very sure of his victory. 1,000 of us, fully armed, are going. And there, you know, their intelligence must have informed them that the Muslims, you know, they are only 300 or so. And they are without arms. So he was so sure of victory. He said, this is going to be Yawmul Furqan. That is why Allah said in Surah Al-Anfal, إِن تَسْتَفْتَهُ فَقَدْ جَاكُمُ الْفَتْحُ وَإِن تَعُودُوا نَعُودُ. If you wanted a judgment, the judgment has already come. The same, وَاسْتَفْتَهُ وَخَابَ كُلُّ جَبَّارٍ عَدِيدٍ. They wanted a judgment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Judgment came. And you know, those people who were tyrants and obstinate, they were disappointed. مِن وَرَائِهِ جَهَنَّمُ. This destruction, you know, in this world, that was only the preliminary chastisement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Min warai jahannam, behind him, behind this chastisement of this world, is the jahannam, that is the real abode, that is the real punishment. Wa yusqa min ma'in sadeed, and they will be given to drink boiling and foul-smelling water. Ma'un sadeed. Yatajarrahu wa la yakadu yusighuhu. They will try to sip. Due to the thirst, you know, sip the water. But they won't be able to swallow it. It will be so foul-smelling, boiling. وَيَاتِهِ الْمَوْتُ مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ. They will see that death is coming from every corner, from every side death is coming. وَمَا هُوَ بِمَيِّتْ. But he will not be able to die. Condition will be as if death is coming. He will be in such a distress that any moment the death is coming from this side or this side. يَاتِهِ الْمَوْتُ مِنْ كُلِّ مَكَانٍ. وَمَا هُوَ بِمَيِّتْ. Only if he could die, he would have been freed from the torment. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not let him die. As we have read, if their skins will be burnt, we shall give them new skins, so that they must keep on tasting, you know, keep tasting the fire, you know, because only these skins are sensitive. Beneath this, you know, our tissues, they are not sensitive. So the skins will be again replaced. وَمِنْ وَرَائِهِ عَذَابٌ غَلِيظٌ. And behind that, more harsh chastisement. مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ كَرَمَادٍ اشْتَدَّتْ بِهِ الرِّيحُ فِي يَوْمٍ عَاصِفٍ. This is one of the very important ayat of the Quran. Because even the worst of the kuffar, and even the worst of the people who make shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they also do some good deeds to satisfy their souls, to satisfy their conscience. Even the worst criminals, they also do something. The dacoits, you know, we have stories in the Indian subcontinent, that the dacoits were very cruel, but they used to help the widows, the orphans, and so on. Even, you know, the women who sell their bodies, they also, in Ashura Muharram, you'll find them, that they are wearing black robes, and, you know, they are with the taziya, and you know, they are also setting up sabils for the people who are there with that procession. Because they also have conscience, you know, and they have to satisfy their conscience. But what is the reality of the good deeds, the virtuous deeds of such people, who are not at the level of iman, real iman? If the real iman is not there, but they have some good deeds, what is going to happen to these good deeds? مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ. The similitude of those who disbelieve their Lord. أَعْمَالُهُمْ. Their good deeds will be كَرَمَادٍ اشْتَدَّتْ بِهِ الرِّيحُ فِي يَوْمٍ عَاصِمٍ. Just like ashes upon which the wind blows hard on a stormy day. A heap of ashes. A very strong wind comes, just scatters all of the ashes. Nothing left. All these virtuous deeds, the so-called good deeds, public service acts and so forth, they will just be habam mansura. They will be just thrown away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not give them any weight. يَقْدِرُونَ لَا يَقْدِرُونَ مِمَّا كَسِبُوا عَلَى شَيْءٍ. They will have no power over what they ought, that they have earned. They thought that we have earned a lot. We did good doors. We established the foundations and such charitable institutions. All these things we have done. So they will be hoping to have some reward. But you know, there will be nothing. Because we shall find another simile in Surah An-Nur. كَسَرَابٍ بِخِيَةٍ يَحْسَبُهُ الظَّمْآنُ مَا. Just like a mirage in the desert, you know. The thirstiest thinks that it's the water. Goes on, goes on, goes on, goes on. But it's no water. It's all mirage. Nothing of the sort. So like that, they feel we have something on our credit side. We have at least, if we didn't believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, okay, we committed an error. But we, you know, we have been doing such and such good deeds. أَجَعَلْتُمْ سِقَايَةَ الْحَاجِّ وَعِبَارَةَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ. We have, you know, read that ayah in Surah At-Tawbah. مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ كَرَمَادٍ اشْتَدَّتْ بِهِ الرِّيحُ فِي يَوْمٍ عَاصِفٍ لَا يَقْدِرُونَ مِمَّا كَسَبُوا عَلَى شَيْءٍ ذَلِكَ هُوَ الضَّلَالُ الْبَعِيدُ. This is a failure of a high degree. They have gone far astray. أَلَمْ تَرَ أَنَّ اللَّهَ خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ. Don't you see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created all the heavens and the earth بالحق, with a purpose, a definite design. إِنْ يَشَا يُذْهِبْكُمْ, if he likes, he will take you away. وَيَعْتَ بِخَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ. And he has all the power. His creative activity has not exhausted. He can bring another creation in your place. وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ. And there is no great matter for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Nothing very heavy. وَبَرَضُوا لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا. And all of them will stand before Allah. They will appear before Allah. فَقَالَ الزُّعَفَاءُ لِلَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا. Now in every nation, every society, there are people who hold the reins of power. And the general masses, common people, they follow them. Now these people will say to them, well, you were our leaders, we followed you. You took us on that path. Now can you save us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala here? Then can we avail of your services here? وَبَرَضُوا لِلَّهِ جَمِيعًا فَقَالَ الزُّعَفَاءُ لِلَّذِينَ اسْتَكْبَرُوا. The haughty and the arrogant, the weak people will say to them, إِنَّا كُنَّا لَكُمْ تَبَعًا. We were your followers. We took you as our leaders. We believed in you. فَهَلْ أَنْتُمْ مُغْنُونَ عَنَّا مِنْ عَذَابِ اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. Now can you save us from the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? وَقَالُوا, they will reply, لَوْ هَدَانَ اللَّهُ لَهَدَيْنَاكُمْ. Had Allah guided us, we would have guided you. سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْنَا جَزَيْنَا أَمْ صَبَرْنَا. Now it's all equal. If we bewail or we take whatever is coming to us, we endure it patiently. مَا لَنَا مِنْ مَحِيصٍ. We have no place of escape. We are equal here. The leaders and the led, both will be in that punishment and chastisement. Nobody will be able to help anybody. وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانُ. Very beautiful presentation of what will be the end of this shaitan. وَقَالَ الشَّيْطَانُ. And Satan would say, لَمَّا قُضِيَ الْأَمْرُ. When everything had been decided, all the cases of all human beings, you know, decided, he will now address those who had followed him. إِنَّ اللَّهَ وَعَدَكُمْ وَعَدَ الْحَقِّ. Listen, Allah also gave you promise, and that was a true promise. فَوَعَدْتُكُمْ فَأَخْلَقْتُكُمْ. I also gave you my promises, but I couldn't fulfill them. مَمَا كَانَ لِي عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانِ. I had no power over you. I could not compel anyone of you to follow me. I had no authority over you. مَا كَانَ لِي عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْ سُلْطَانِ. إِلَّا أَنْ دَعَوْتُكُمْ. Except that I called you. فَاسْتَجَبْتُمْ لِي. You accepted. You responded. You followed me. فَلَا تَلُومُونِي وَلُومُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Now don't blame me. Blame your own selves. مَا أَنَا بِمُسْخِلِكُمْ. I cannot come to you to your help. وَمَا أَنْتُمْ مُسْلِخِيَّ. Nor you can come to my help. إِنِّي كَفَرْتُ بِمَا أَشْرَكْتُمُونِي مِنْ قَبْلِ. I declare my denial of what you were making me equal to Allah before this. I declare. إِنِّي كَفَرْتُ بِمَا أَشْرَكْتُمُونِي مِنْ قَبْلِ. In the days gone by, إِنَّ الظَّالِمِينَ لَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. For all these evildoers, there is going to be a painful chastisement, painful punishment.
وَأُدْخِلَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ جَنَّاتٍ And those who had belief, who had iman, and who had done good deeds, they will be made to enter. They will be admitted to Jannah, to the gardens, تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِ الْأَنْهَارِ Underneath which rivers will be flowing. خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهِمْ And they will dwell there forever with the leave of their Lord. تَحَيَّتُهُمْ فِيهَا سَلَامْ Their greetings in that will be salam. أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا كَلِمَةً طَيِّبَةً كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ أَصْلُهَا ثَابِتٌ وَفَرْعُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ Don't you see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has struck a similitude, a parable, of a goodly word, just word, correct word, كَلِمَةُ الْحَقِّ كَلِمَةَ الطَّيِّبَةِ كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ It's just like a good tree, أَصْلُهَا ثَابِتٌ whose root is fixed in the land, وَفَرُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ and its branches are in the heavens. And if from every seed comes out a tree, even a good word, a word of justice, a virtuous word, that is how very profound in the eyes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A good, idea, the correct ideology, the correct dawah, all these things, although they are only words. When Muhammad started preaching, it was all words, nothing else. But these words were so, profound, that from these words grew the movement. And that movement, in only 20 years' time, it brought about a big revolution. Now that big tree of Khilafat-e-Rashida, where from did it grow? It grew from the words of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he was preaching in the streets of Makkah. أَلَمْ تَرَ كَيْفَ ضَرَبَ اللَّهُ مَثَلًا كَلِمَةً طَيِّبَةً كَشَجَرَةٍ طَيِّبَةٍ أَصْلُهَا ثَابِتٌ وَفَرُعُهَا فِي السَّمَاءِ تُؤْتِي أُكُلَهَا كُلَّ حِينٍ And this tree, it is giving its fruit in every season. بِإِذْنِ رَبِّهَا With the leave and the permission of its Lord. وَيَضْرِبُ اللَّهُ الْأَمْثَالَ لِلنَّاسِ And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala strikes these parables and similitudes for the mankind. لَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَذَكَّرُونَ That they should be admonished and reminded. وَمَثَلُ كَلِمَةٍ خَبِيثَةٍ كَشَجَرَةٍ خَبِيثَةٍ اجْتُثَّتْ مِنْ فَوْقِ الْأَرْضِ مَا لَهَا مِنْ قَرَارٍ And a foul word, although for some time being it might appear to be effective, but its similitude of a foul word is of a foul tree. Uprooted from above the earth. It has no roots. No roots. It can be uprooted at any moment from above the earth. It is only superficially attached to the earth. مَا لَهَا مِنْ قَرَارٍ There is not going to be any stability in it. All falsehood has no stability. All truth has the roots down deep into the soil. But it might appear that this false thing is very, awful. But actually, if you look to the reality, it is nothing. يُثْبِتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ السَّابِتِ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا Just like these words, good word, bad word, foul word. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps firm those who believe with a firm word in the life of this world and the hereafter. And what is the biggest, kalimatu tayyibah? لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. يُثْبِتُ اللَّهُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِالْقَوْلِ السَّابِتِ This is the creed, this is the foundation of Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives firmness to those who believe. فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ In this world also and in the hereafter. فَيُضِلُّ اللَّهُ الظَّالِمِينَ And Allah sends the evildoers astray. وَيَفْعَلُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءَ And Allah does whatever He likes. أَلَمْ تَرَى إِلَى الَّذِينَ بَدَّلُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ كُفْرًا وَأَهَلُّوا قَوْمَهُمْ دَارَ الْبَوَارِ Have you not seen or thought about those people? Who exchanged the bounty of Allah with ingratitude. Allah gave them Quran, the biggest blessing, and they are thankless, they are not grateful, they are not reading it, they are not accepting it, they are not making it the light for their lives, not making it the imam for their, conduct in life. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ بَدَّلُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ كُفْرًا وَأَحَلُّوا قَوْمَهُمْ دَارَ الْبَوَارِ And these are the people who alight or who will make their nation to descend The place of destruction. Jahannama. What is that place of destruction? Jahannam. Yaslaunaha. They will enter it. وَبِئْسَ الْقَرَارِ And it's the evil place of stay. وَجَعَلُوا لِلَّهِ أَنْدَادًا لِيُضِلُّوا عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ And they have concocted for Allah rivals, equals and rivals, so that they can lead people astray from his path. قُلْ تَمَتَّعُوا. Tell to them, okay, enjoy for some time. You can enjoy in this life, in this world, for some time. تَمَتَّعُوا. فَإِنَّ مَسِيرَكُمْ إِلَى النَّارِ. But you know, your return is to the fire. قُلْ لِعِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا يُقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ. Tell my bondsmen who have come to believe in me, they should establish prayer. وَيُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ. And they should keep on expending from whatever we have given them. سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً. Secretly and also openly. مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ يَوْمٌ. Before, until that, before that days come, that day comes. لَا بَعُنْ فِيهِ وَلَا خِلَالٍ. The day of hereafter, the day of judgment, when there will be no bargaining, no selling, no purchasing, and no befriending. No friend will be able to help you. Before that day comes, you spend in the way of Allah, and you earn whatever you can earn for your own self. Allahu alladhi khalaqa samawati wal arda wa anzala minas samai ma. Allah is He who created all the heavens and the earth, and He sent down from the heaven the water. فَأَخْرَجَ بِهِ مِنَ الثَّمَرَاتِ رِزْقًا لَكُمْ. And with that water, He brought out from the shape of fruits, the risk for you, the food and sustenance for you. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْفُلْكَ لِتَجْرِيَ فِي الْبَحْرِ بِأَمْرِهِ. And He has subjected for you the ships and the boats so that they should, you know, float in the ocean or in the river. فِي الْبَحْرِ بِأَمْرِهِ. By His command. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ الْأَنْهَارِ. And He has subjected for you, for your favor, these rivers which irrigate lands. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمْ الشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ دَائِبَيْنِ. And He has subjected for you this sun and the moon. And they are constant, دَائِبَيْنِ, constant upon their courses. وَسَخَّرَ لَكُمُ اللَّيْلَ وَالنَّهَارِ. And He has subjected for you, for your benefit, the night and the day. وَآتَاكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ مَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُ. And He has given you whatever, all that you have asked Him. And now this asking is knowingly also, unknowingly also. He has provided with so many things about which we don't know that we needed it. Today we have discovered these are the vitamins, and these are, you know, these are needed. But Allah had already provided them. We have only discovered them. We could never ask Him, oh Allah, give us the vitamins. He put these vitamins in all these things. Although we had not asked for them, we had not known that they are necessary for our body, for our, you know, normal working of the body. So whatever you knowingly or unknowingly, whatever you required and whatever you asked for, He provided you. وَآتَاكُمْ مِنْ كُلِّ مَا سَأَلْتُمُوهُ وَإِنْ تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you want to count the blessings of Allah, you won't be able to reckon them. إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظَلُومٌ كَفَّارٌ. But man is very much evil doing and ungrateful. He doesn't show gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala over all His bounties. وَإِذْ قَالَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ رَبِّ اجْعَلْ هَٰذَا الْبَلَدَ آمِنًا. Now the story of Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam. Just recall when Ibrahim prayed to his Lord, رَبِّ اجْعَلْ هَٰذَا الْبَلَدَ آمِنًا. Oh my Lord, make this city of Makkah, a place of peace and security. وَجْنُبْنِي وَبَنَيَّ نَعْبُدَ الْأَصْنَامِ. And please save me and my progeny from worshipping these idols. رَبِّ إِنَّهُنَّ أَضْلَلْنَ كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ. Oh my Lord, these idols have led so many people astray. People have been worshipping them and gone, you know, to the wrong paths. So save me and my... Now this is the picture being shown to people who thought that they were the progeny of Ibrahim, who claimed that they were followers of Ibrahim. Now what did Ibrahim say? He said, and he prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please keep my progeny safe from the worship of these idols. And you have placed 360 idols in that house that he built for the prayers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَبَّ إِنَّهُنَّ أَضْلَلْنَ كَثِيرًا مِنَ النَّاسِ فَمَنْ تَبِعَنِي فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي. So whosoever follows me, then he is from me, he is my ummah, he belongs to me. وَمَنْ عَصَانِي فَإِنَّكَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. And but whosoever disobeys me, he goes astray, then you are the forgiving, the merciful. You know, this is the way Hazrat Masih alayhi salam, you know, we read in the end of Suratul Maidah. What will he say on the day of judgment? In tu'azibhum fa innahum ibaduk wa in taghfir lahum fa innaka ala kulli shay'in qadir. If you punish them, Well, they are your creatures, they are your bondsmen. You can do anything you like. But if you forgive them, you are Ghafoor and Rahim, you are Ala Kulli Shay'in Qadeer. Nobody can ask you why you have forgiven them. This is the most subtle way, you know, of appealing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The same are the upbringings. فَمَنْ تَبِعَنِي فَإِنَّهُ مِنِّي. Whosoever followed me, well, he's saved because he belongs to me. وَمَنْ عَصَانِي. But as for those who disobey me, فَإِنَّكَ غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. For them, you know, I invoke your maghfirah and your rahmah. رَبَّنَا إِنِّي أَسْكَنْتُ مِنْ ذُرِّيَّتِي بِوَادٍ غَيْرِ ذِي زَرْعٍ. Oh, my Lord, I have made a branch of my progeny settle here in this valley, which is uncultivable, which has no cultivation, due to your command. In the Baytik al-Muharram, near your house, which is, you know, very sacred house. رَبَّنَا لِيُقِيمُ السَّلَاةِ. What for? Oh, our Lord, so that they should establish prayer here. فَجَعَلْ أَفْدَةً مِنَ النَّاسِ تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ. So now you make the hearts of some people. They should incline towards them. Inclining towards them, leaning towards them. Be soft and kind to them. تَهْوِي إِلَيْهِمْ وَرْزُقْهُمْ مِنَ السَّمَرَاتِ. And now it's on to you to provide them with fruits. There's no cultivation here. No water. Land is incultivable. Now it's upon you. It's your, you know, I request you that you provide this progeny of mine, this Bani Ismail, مِنَ السَّمَرَاتِ لَعَلَّهُمْ يَشْكُرُونَ, with the fruits, so that they should be grateful. رَبَّنَا إِنَّكَ تَعْلَمُ مَا نُخْفِي وَمَا نُعْلِنُ. Oh, our Lord, you very well know what we hide in our hearts and what we reveal and say openly. وَمَا يَخْفَى عَلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ. And nothing is hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, neither in the heavens nor in the earth. Alhamdulillah alladhi wahab li ala al-kibar Ismail wa Ishaq. All praise be to Allah, who bestowed upon me, despite my old age. Ibrahim was 87 years old when Hazrat Ismail was born. And he was full 100 years of age when Hazrat Ishaq was born. Wa'aza bali shaykha. You read it, you know, in Surah Uhud. Hazrat Sarah saying, this husband of mine is also grown old. I am also ujuz. I am a very old woman. How can I give birth to a child? But you know, that was the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ishaq. She bore him and Hazrat Ismail was 100 years old. Alhamdulillah, Hazrat Ibrahim was 100 years old. Hazrat Ismail was 13 years elder to Hazrat Ishaq. Alhamdulillah, alladhi wahab li al-kibar Ismail wa Ishaq. He bestowed upon me Ismail and Ishaq, despite my old age. Inna Rabbi la sami'u du'a. Verily, my Lord is the listener of the prayer. Rabbi ij'alni muqima salati wa min zurriyati. Oh, my Lord, you make me establish this salah. And from my progeny also. رَبَّنَا وَتَقَبَّلْ دُعَائِي. O our Lord, please accept my prayer. رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ. And O our Lord, forgive me and my parents. وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And all the believers. يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْحِسَابِ. The day when, you know, reckoning is taken. Reckoning is done. Comes to pass. وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ اللَّهَ غَافِلًا عَمَّا يَعْمَلُ الظَّالِمُونَ. The concluding section of this surah. Never think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unaware from whatever these evildoers are doing. If we are not punishing them right now, don't think that we don't know what they are doing. إِنَّمَا يُؤَخِّرُهُمْ لِيَوْمٍ. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is postponing them, giving them a respite. لِيَوْمٍ. For that day, تَشْخَصُ فِي الْأَبْصَارِ. On which eyes will be, you know, stared in terror. When there is khawf, terror, you know, the eyes are fixed at some point. تَشْخَثُ الْأَفْسِهِ الْأَبْصَارِ. مُهْتِعِينَ مُقْنِعِي رُؤُسِهِمْ. They'll be running forward, their heads upward. لَا يَرْتَدُّ إِلَيْهِمْ طَرْفُهُمْ. Their glances will not return towards them. وَافِدَتُهُمْ هَوَا and their hearts will be just empty. وَانْذَرِ النَّاسَ يَوْمَ يَاتِهِمُ الْعَذَابِ and warn, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that on the day this azab will come, فَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا. Now these evildoers, you know, they are challenging Allah, challenging Muhammad, denying, you know, arrogantly, haughtily. But on that day they will say, رَبَّنَا أَخِرْنَا إِذَا عَجَرٍ قَرِيبٍ. Oh, our Lord, just respite us for a small more period, some time, some, you know, time fixed, which might be very qareeb, very near. نُجِبْ دَعْوَتَكَ. We shall respond positively to your call. فَنَتَّبِعِ الرُّسُلِ. And we shall follow the messengers. أَوَلَمْ تَكُونُوا أَقْسَمْتُمْ مِنْ قَبْلُ عَلَكُمْ مِنْ زَوَالٍ. Were you not swearing before that there can never come to you any decline? You are sure of your powers and stability. أَوَلَمْ تَكُونُوا أَقْسَمْتُمْ. You were swearing that there can be no decline to us. وَسَكَنْتُمْ فِي مَسَاكِنِ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا. And you lived in the houses, in the dwellings of those who were evildoers. ظَلَمُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَتَبَيَّنَ لَكُمْ كَيْفَ فَعَلْنَا بِهِمْ. And it was all clear to you what we had done to them, what we had done to Samud, what we had done to Aad. You were dwelling in the same area. You knew what came to them. وَضَرَبْنَا لَكُمُ الْأَمْثَالِ. And we struck similitudes for you. وَقَدْ مَكَرُوا مَكْرَهُمْ وَعِنْدَ اللَّهِ مَكْرَهُمْ. They also tried their best, devised plots and they all everything. But all their plots are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, under His control. وَإِنْ كَانَ مَكْرُهُمْ لَتَزُولَ مِنْهُ الْجِبَالِ. And definitely, their devices and their plannings were so great that they could move even the mountains. Whatever they were devising and deciding for Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, all the elders of the clans of Quraysh assembled in a house, in Darul Nadwa, their parliament, and they could do anything, but what Allah did to them. فَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ اللَّهَ مُخْلِفَ بَعْدِهِ رُسُلَهِ. Never think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not going to fulfill His promise with His messengers, to go back on His words which He has given to His messengers. إِنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ ذُو انْتِقَامٍ. Verily Allah is all-powerful. He holds all authority. And He is the Lord of retribution, of vengeance. يَوْمَ تُبَدَّلُ الْأَرْضُ غَيْرَ الْأَرْضِ. When this earth will be changed to something else, it will take some other form. It will not remain round. It will be made, you know, leveled. دُكَّتِ الْأَرْضُ دَكَّاً دَكَّا. وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ. In the same way, these heavens will be changed. وَبَرَضُوا لِلَّهِ الْوَاحِدِ الْقَهَّارِ. And they will all appear before Allah, the One and the Irresistible and the Omnipotent One. وَتَرَى الْمُجْرِمِينَ يَوْمَئِذٍ مُقَرَّنِينَ فِي الْأَصْفَادِ. And you will see these culprits, these criminals on that day. They will all be linked together in chains. سَرَابِيلُهُمْ مِنْ قَطِرَانٍ. And you know, their robes and their clothes will be of pitch. Or you may say sulfur that catches fire immediately. وَتَخْشَى وَجُوهَهُمُ النَّارِ. And fire will be covering their faces. لِيَجْزِيَ اللَّهُ كُلَّ نَفْسٍ مَا كَسَبَتْ. So that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala recompenses every soul what it had earned. إِنَّ اللَّهَ سَرِيُّ الْحِسَابِ. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is swift in reckoning. هَذَا بَلَاغٌ لِلنَّاسِ. Behold, this is the message for the mankind. وَلَيُنْزَرُوا بِهِ. So that they are warned with this. وَلَيَعْلَمُوا أَنَّمَا هُوَ إِلَهُ وَاحِدٌ. And so that they should come to know, come to believe, be convinced that He is the One, the Lord, the One, واحد. لِيَذَّكَّرُوا أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. وَلَيَذَّكَّرَ أُولُو الْأَلْبَابِ. And so that those who reflect, who have the understanding, who have the intellect, who can use their intellect, they should be reminded, they should be admonished. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.
The Islamic Organization of North America, IONA, is an organization dedicated to reviving the Quran into the hearts of Muslims while bringing its message to non-Muslims. The obligations of a Muslim as ordained by the Quran and Sunnah can be understood as having four levels. 1. A Muslim is required to develop real faith and conviction, iman, in one's heart. 2. A Muslim is required to live a life of complete submission to the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. 3. A Muslim is required to propagate and disseminate the message of Islam to humanity as a whole. 4. A Muslim is required to try his utmost in establishing the just Islamic order. The first and foremost objective of establishing IONA is to assist the Muslims in North America to uphold and implement these obligations, first on themselves, their families, inform their friends, and then to invite the non-Muslims to Islam. The ultimate goal is to seek Allah's pleasure and salvation in the hereafter. For more information about IONA, please visit us at www.tanzeem.us. You may also email us at info@tanzeem.us or call our toll-free number 866-779-IONA. Join us. Together we can make a difference.